Bagolini's striated glasses can be used to assess sensory function in strabismus. They can help determine presence of diplopia, suppression, presence of anomalous retinal correspondence, as well as the presence of the monofixation syndrome. What is special about these lenses? Like Madoc's rod, they also convert a point source of light into a straight line. They are less dissociating than a Madoc's rod. In fact, they are the least dissociating of all the sensory tests. They permit near normal viewing and fusion, and cover testing can be performed simultaneously while wearing the lenses. This is a binocular test. After performing a cover test to determine the presence of atropia, the lenses are placed in front of the eyes such that the striations are placed from the patient's point of view at 135 degrees in front of the right eye and 45 degrees in front of the left eye. That is, the striations are oriented upward and inward, and the patient is asked to fixate on distant light. Since the streak of light is seen perpendicular to the striations, the patient will see a line in this direction from the right eye and this direction from the left eye. So, in a normal person, the binocular fusion response looks like this. Since the patient has near normal vision through Bagolini lenses, the central fixation light is also seen. Let's see some examples. Scenario 1. The patient sees this. This is essentially what a normal person sees, but cover testing reveals the presence of a tropia. Since both lines are seen, there is no suppression. The light is single, so no diplopia. The lines cross in the center, so there is binocular fusion. So this is a case of an ocular deviation with anomalous retinal correspondence. So this pattern with no deviation indicates normal retinal correspondence, and in the presence of a deviation indicates ARC. Scenario 2, this is what the patient sees. A single light, so no diplopia. In fact, only the line from the left eye is seen. Cover test shows the presence of a tropia. So this is a case of a right tropia with suppression. Scenario 3, this is what the patient sees. How do we interpret this? Since only a single light is seen, there is no diplopia. Since lines from both eyes are seen, there is no gross suppression. Both lines cross each other exactly in the middle, which means there is fusion. The line from the right eye has a small central gap. This is a foveal suppression scotoma, and this is a classic case of monofixation syndrome. In monofixation syndrome, there is a foveal suppression scotoma in one eye with peripheral fusion. Cover testing will reveal either no deviation or a tropia of less than or equal to 10 prism diopters. Scenario 4. This is what the patient sees. Here, two lights are seen, so there is diplopia. This, of course, means that there is a deviation and there is no suppression. Let's see the type of diplopia. The light seen on the right belongs to the right eye, so the diplopia is uncrossed. So the patient has an esotropia, which is what the cover test would show. So this is a case of a right esotropia with normal retinal correspondence and absence of suppression. Scenario 5, this is what the patient sees. Here again, there are two lights, so diplopia is present. Again, this means there is a deviation and no suppression. Here, the light seen on the right belongs to the left eye, so the diplopia is crossed, so the cover test will show an exotropia. So this is a right exotropia with normal retinal correspondence and absence of suppression. Sometimes, depending on the deviation, there may be a greater horizontal separation of images, or if there is a vertical component, the images may be vertically separated as well.